Class 9 Federal Board online class, subject is chemistry. Today we will start first chapter fundamentals of chemistry and the topic is chemistry and its branches. Learning object of this lecture, at the end of this lecture you will be able to define chemistry, identify and provide examples of different branches of chemistry, differentiate between branches of chemistry. Before going to explain chemistry, first we discuss what is matter. Anything that has mass and occupies space is called matter. So, according to this definition, everything in the universe is matter, like water, wood, air, paper, all these things are matter because they have mass and they occupy space. Now we discuss the definition of chemistry. Chemistry is a branch of science that deals with properties, composition, and structure of matter. So, what is mean by composition of matter? Let us consider the example of water. It is a matter. The composition of water means it is a combination of two hydrogen and one oxygen atom, which is chemically combined. So, hydrogen and oxygen atom is the composition of water molecule. Now, second is the structure of matter. Structure of matter depends upon the composition of matter. In water, hydrogen and oxygen are combined to form water molecule. How these atoms are arranged in water molecule, this is structure of matter. Third is properties of matter. There are two types of properties, physical properties and chemical properties. Physical properties related to physical states of matter, like what is the physical state of water? It is a liquid. Its smell, melting point, freezing point, all these properties are physical. Chemical properties depend upon chemical composition of matter. In water, hydrogen and oxygen are combined. If we decompose water, it breaks into hydrogen and oxygen. The composition is changed, so its properties also change. I hope you will understand the definition of chemistry. Now we discuss the branches of chemistry. There are various branches of chemistry. First we discuss about physical chemistry. Physical chemistry is the study of laws and theories that describe the structure and changes of matter. Actually, it deals with the behavior of materials. For example, if you take a bottle of water and put it into the freezer, after some time, water turns into ice. The bottle is expand and break. That's a physical chemistry. How material is behave when you do some things with materials. Second is organic chemistry. Organic chemistry is the study of compounds of carbon and hydrogen, such as fuels, plastic, food additives, and drugs. Excluding simple salts like carbonates, carbides, and oxides. Actually, it is a study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives. For example, methane, its molecular formula is CH4, which is a natural gas. Derivative means those compounds which derive from hydrocarbons. Third is inorganic chemistry. Inorganic chemistry is the study of all elements and their compound other than carbon and hydrocarbons. Actually, inorganic chemistry covers all the material which are not organic and term as non-living organisms. Those compounds which do not contain carbon-hydrogen bond, such as catalysts, crystals, minerals, metals, etc. Next is biochemistry. Bio means life. Biochemistry is the chemistry of life or chemistry of living organisms, in which we study the physical and chemical changes that occur in living organisms. Next is industrial chemistry. Industrial chemistry is the chemistry of industry. It deals with the manufacture of chemical substance on commercial scale. For example, glass, paper, chlorine, ammonia, etc. Six is nuclear chemistry. Nuclear chemistry is the chemistry of nucleus, in which we study the changes that occur in nuclei. Seventh is environmental chemistry. Environmental chemistry deals with the chemical and toxic substances that pollute the environment and their effect on human beings. In environmental chemistry, we study the components of environments and the effect of human activities on environment. For example, water pollution, air pollution, these are the effects of human activities. Last is analytical chemistry. Analytical chemistry deals with the methods and instruments that determine the kind, quality, and quantity of a substances. Actually, it is the study involving how we analyze the chemical compound in a sample. For example, how much caffeine present in a cup of tea, or what is the composition of drinking water. Now, how can we differentiate between different branches of chemistry? Let us consider the compound acetic acid. Its formula is CH3COOH. Its source is vinegar, which contains 5% acetic acid. Its smell is vinegar-like, and it is used to flavor food. Let's see how various types of studies on this compound help us to differentiate between the branches of chemistry. Acetic acid is a carbon compound. The study of its method of preparation and its chemical properties is a part of organic chemistry. The study of all chemical reactions that acetic acid undergoes in the bodies of human beings is called biochemistry. The component of element of acetic acid are carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. The study of these elements is included in inorganic chemistry. Use of technology and ways to obtain acetic acid on large scale is done in chemical industries. So, it is a part of industrial chemistry. Explanation of conversion of acetic acid from solid to liquid and liquid to gaseous state and vice versa. The application of laws and theories to understand its structure. These two types of studies are a part of physical chemistry. The method and instrument used to determine its percentage, composition, melting and boiling points, etc. are studied in analytical chemistry. The study of any adverse effect of the compound or the compounds that derive from it on the human is a part of environmental chemistry. The study of radioactive radiations or neutron on the compound is a part of nuclear chemistry. Now it's time to give you some home task. Do self-assessment exercise that is related. Do self-assessment exercise 1.1. Review question number 2, part 3. Review question number 6.